Okay, good afternoon. I think my slide is visible from your side. Okay, so today I discussed about the basic ideas on electric welding. Okay, so before starting that module, so we need to know about what is electric welding. And you know that one, before starting any of the topic, I'll discuss the basic thing, that what, why and how. Means what is the motivations of this chapter and why it is important and how we are going to implement that chapter. Okay, so what is the motivation of this chapter? Basically, the motivations of this subjects, you can understand that totally you are giving the main thrust, okay, to show to different applications of electrical engineering, okay, in the different field, okay, the applications of electrical engineering in different. Started with electric tractions. Okay, that means you know that what are the importance of the traction. Then we'll discuss another important electric application, that is electric heating. And electric welding is the continuations of the electric heating. Basically, what happened in electrical welding? So by heating, we are giving as a input energy as a what? We are giving the input as a electrical energy, and the output is heat energy. So we are converting, okay, efficiently converting, okay. So there are different conventional methodology to provide the heat energy, to produce the heat energy from different, from the chemical energy to heat energy. Other methods, if you see different literature, you can understand the different methodologies to provide the heat energy. Okay, but electrical heating means you are getting more efficiently, you are providing or you are producing the heat most efficiently from the electrical energy. Okay, and what are the advantages for it? So overall pollution is less. Okay, that's your basic advantage. Overall pollution is less, and you are getting that and you are controlling that heat energy very smooth manner. Okay, that is your most important features of electrical heating. Then how it will be relevant with your electrical welding? So heat energy means you are using that heat energy to welding purpose. Welding means what happened? Sometimes you know that different methodologies of the weldings, you are aware about it. Basically, when you are in first year, I think you have attended different workshop, okay, in institute workshop. So for different types of welding, you have studied and you have practically implemented, okay, in the I think central workshop you have attended different classes, okay, means factory shop and different shop are there, welding shop, okay. In first year it is important, and you can understand that basically that we are converting electrical energy heat energy, then heat energy is using for that welding purpose. That's the motivation. So electrical welding means you are giving the electrical energy and your output is coming in the form of welding in the different field of applications. Okay, that's the motivations. Okay, so why it is important? That you know that if we are using the electrical processes, so then the main advantages is that the energy efficiency. Energy efficiency, why? That means much more energy efficient other than the conventional methodology. Okay, that's why we are giving more thrust or more focused on electrical welding, means electrical applications in different heating welding purpose. Okay, another important module was there, that was illuminations. Okay, that is also in the conversion of the electrical energy to the lighting bond concepts. Okay, and the different field of applications, different problems was there, and different standard lighting phenomenon was there. Okay, that's the methodology. Okay, so I think you are able to understand what is electric welding, how it is important, and why it is important and how. Okay, how means there are different methods of welding, like your arc heating. So here also the arc welding is there. Then you know that is resistive welding also be there. Okay, so resistive heating was there, resistive welding is there. Then you know that different new names also be there, like laser welding, laser beam welding. Okay, then infrared welding, infrared heating also be there. So it's a continuations like that thing. Okay, so very interesting chapter, and you can here we are going to discuss about different methodologies of that electric welding. Okay, so first we need to know that what is electric welding. So from the definitions, okay, that welding. So what is welding? Welding is a process. Okay, welding is the process of joining two pieces of metal, okay, or non-metal at face rendered plastic or the liquid, okay, by the application of heat or the pressure both. Filler material may be used to effect of the union. So welding means what? So you are connecting, you are going to join two or more than two metal or the non-metal. Okay, non-metal means sometimes right now you know that cable joint or cable welding. Okay, you know that there are different faults. Okay, in cable faults means puncture of the cable faults, or you want to join the cable faults. So what happened? The cable material is one kinds of insulating material, means it's based on the plastic, rubber, different compositions are there, not exact plastic, different compositions of polymer. Okay, so joining of the polymers is not the metal. Okay, so filler material may be based on your compositions of your objects. Okay, if it is metal, so definitely filler material also been there like that way. Okay, some filler material is look like a metal, so that you can use there to joining them. Okay, so that are the examples of that's at the basic definitions of the electric welding. Now what are the different processes of welding? Okay, that I am telling you. So what are the most important processes? So basically you know that there are different classifications. Okay, so I have mentioned here different classifications of welding process. So first one is your fusion welding. Okay, so fusion welding. Second one is your non-fusion welding. So two are the main important processes are there. So that is fusion welding, another one is non-fusion welding. Okay, so in fusion welding what happened and what is non-fusion welding? Okay, so that in fusion welding again it having two broadly classifications are there. That is what, based on the heat produced by the electrical energy, that I am that I have already told you. So based on that electrical energy, that is called first is fusion welding. Okay, another one is that based on the heat produced by the chemical welding. So both the cases heat is important. Basically without presence of heat you are not making the filler material. That filler material is important to making the union between two metals or two non-metals. Or sometimes what happened if it is plastic, so plastic or liquid is not directly possible, but some solid material. Okay, you are making welding for the solid material, but there is not changes of the chemical. Okay, there is no chemical changes. Okay, it's some physical properties. Okay, so you are welded two materials. Okay, though there should not be changes any chemical nature. Okay, only the physical changes are there. Okay, so based on that filler material and based on that welding process, you are normally classified into two modes. So first one is the fusion welding, second one is the non-fusion welding. Okay, in fusion welding again it will be classified into two important part. So that is that heat welding, in welding purpose that heat is most important factors. Okay, if you do not give that heat, so it will not be melting down of the filler material. So based on that heat produced, so heat is produced by the electrical energy. Another one is based on the heat produced by chemical energy. So two concepts is important. Okay, so then in case of fusion welding, the point number one, based on the heat produced by the electrical energy, again it will be classified into two most important features. Okay, so first one is the carbon arc welding. So point number one is your carbon arc welding, and point number two is your metal arc welding. Okay, so two types of weldings are there. Arc welding. Okay, so that is first one carbon arc welding, second one is the metal arc welding. So again carbon arc welding is classified into two types, shielded and another is unshielded. Okay, two methods are there. And metal arc welding also been classified into shielded, then unshielded, and other processes are there. Okay, so again that shielded one having some subclasses. Okay, like shielded metal arc welding, inert gas welding. Okay, In case of inert gas welding, there are three types: TIG welding, MIG welding, and MAG welding. MAG welding. Okay, three are the most important thing. And another shielded welding. There are the submerged arc welding and atomic hydrogen welding. So all are the different examples of the metal arc welding. Okay, sorry, shielded metal arc welding. Okay. Next one, unshielded. Another one is other processes. In the other processes, what are the processes? Plasma. Another one is laser. Two are the most important features: plasma as well as the laser. Okay. So based on the heat produced by the chemical energy. Okay. So again, we can categorize into two part of the welding. That is your gas welding, means oxyacetylene cylinder you are using for the gas welding. Another one is thermite welding. So I think you are able to understand what are the different welding processes inside of the fusion welding. Okay, so based on that processes, so you can categorize different parameters. Okay, different types of welding. So here I have mentioned what are the important types of fusion welding. Next, what is important for the non-fusion welding. Okay, so in this case, we have discussed, again it will be categorized into two parts: based on the heat produced by the chemical energy, then based on the heat produced by the mechanical energy, and third one is the based on the heat produced by the electrical energy. Okay, these three are the most important features for the non-fusion welding. In non-fusion welding, it having heat provided by the chemical energy, it having two important features: forged welding, another is oxyacetylene non-fusion welding. Okay, so it is examples of the non-fusion welding. Then based on the mechanical energy welding, so that is friction welding, another is ultrasound welding. Okay, so there are different other methods weldings are also be available. That is called, one is very unknown to us, that is resistance welding. Okay, so again, resistance welding having some sub parts. Okay, so first one is the spot welding, then seam welding. Okay, then projection welding, final one is the butt welding. Butt welding having three important features, that means flash welding, upset welding, and the stud welding. So I think all of you able to understand what are the different classifications of the welding. Okay, so side by side, I think all of you noted down the method of noting down the what are the important what are the important processes of the welding. Okay, so now we'll discuss that individual segments of individual welding methodologies. Okay, what are relevant to us, that we are going to be discussed. So that's the basic motivation of this chapter. Okay, I think till now all of you able to understand. There is actually most of the things are very informative idea, so there are no complicated ones, so we are able easily understandable, I think so. Now we have discussed about different following important factors. Okay, so what are the most important factors for the welding? Okay, so what factors are have create some effects on the welding? Okay, so first, what may be the important factor from your common sense? First one is that what type of metal. Okay, so what type of metal you are going to be used. Okay, so type of metals, then cost involved, how much costing is required, then nature of products to be fabricated, and technique of production adopted. Okay, so first most important features is that which type of metal you are going to be used. Based on your metal selection, your costing will be involved. Okay, so if you are using very inert metal, like you are using that gold, you are making the joint between two gold plate, so definitely gold is an example of a metal. But what will be the problem? Gold is very costly material. So, and basic features of the gold is they are more or less inert in nature. Okay, no, still they are not inert. Okay, means they are chemically active, definitely, but comparatively other elements, other metal elements, metallic elements, okay, gold and platinum, they are chemically, relatively chemically less active, means less reactive, or means chemically less reactive. Okay, now so that's why if you want to join two of the two gold plates, so then you have to select the filler material such a manner that can combine easily. Okay, and if you see that gold having, if you see the melting point of the gold, okay, so that is very high. Okay, so at that point, so filler material you are going to be joined there. So filler material, that is another benefit. Okay, so that material having less melting point compared to your gold. Okay, so if you want to join two metallic body or two metallic part or two non-metallic part, you need to know about the property. Okay, how next one is that which type of metals you are going to be used based on your metal, so you have changed the filler material. Okay, next one is the cost involved, how much cost is involved for that purpose. Okay, so basically sophistication. So if you are using that normal in your workshop, that type of welding, if you are using for your ornaments, gold ornaments, so definitely it will not work. Basically gold ornaments means that welding methods should be very sophisticated manner. Okay, and that precision, and the precision will be more in case of gold ornaments. Okay, but when you are using the same kinds of welding, when you are using the welding in your workshop, the precision is not so important like that ornament preparations. Okay, means joint, making the joint between two metals, means gold material in the ornament. So precision is different as per your precision. So the sophistication of the setup will be decided. Okay, the sophistication of the setup will decide, the costing of the setup will be decided. Okay, I think you are able to understand. So first one is the selection of the metal is important. Second one is the costing of the material. Then what is your third one? Third one is the nature of product to be fabricated. Okay, so which type of product you are going to be used? Nature of product to be fabricated means you want to use the which type of filler material you are, you have selected. So normally we are using for the fabrication, in laboratory fabrication we are using lead. Okay, means we are using lead for the soldering panels. Okay, basically why lead? Basically the lead having the melting point of the lead is less. Also it's not easily meltable in the normal scenario, means normal temperature. Okay, that's why you are normally using lead for our common purpose. But in case of joint of the but in case of joint of the two iron material, okay, so which type of material you have to use, so that you have to select. So when you are using it for the designing of any of the window or any of the architectural structure, for this case which type of joining is required, so that also related to the expansion of the material, expansion of the material. Okay, so in that case the conductivity is not important. See, that lead material having good conductivity, that's why for our electronic circuit fabrication we are using the lead material, but we are not using it for a normal but in case of welding, means conventional welding, so we are not going to use directly that lead material. We are using some other materials, means some amalgam of the other materials. Then we are using some precautions. Okay, so providing or protecting your welding. So technique of products adopted. Okay, which products you are going to be adapt, so that is important. That's the important features for the factors of the efficiency factor, efficiency of your welding. Okay, so sophistication, costing, and material selection, and the filler material selection, that all are the very important features. Now we have discussed the resistive welding. Okay, so resistive welding, then arc welding. Okay, so what about the resistive welding? So you know that material is used like a resistive material, so I discussed it in the heating, in the chapter of heating. So charge material we are using, so we are considering the resistance of the charge material, then current is flowing through that material, and that may cause for I square R T electrical energy for melting down that material. So it's a resistance welding. Okay, so in this method, what happened in this method, the current, okay, in this method the current is passed through the inherent resistance the joint to be welded, thereby the generating of the heat as per the equation of I square RT kilojoules. Okay, so whatever the current is passing through that filler material is placed in between two joint, okay, in between the joints of the two metals. Okay, if the current is passing through there, so that may cause for melting down of that material. Okay, and if the current is not flowing there, so automatically the heat, that I square RT heat, that will be provide the so heat energy is provided for the elliptical, sorry, current, means the current. Okay, so that will responsible, okay, that will responsible for melting down that filler material. Then current is not there, so automatically it will be concentrated, means it will be cooled down and it will connect, means joint to metal, make the combination in joint, make the joint between the two metals, okay, two metal face. Okay, that is your resistance welding. Next one is that arc welding. Okay, so what is your arc welding? Arcing, so basically resistance welding, from the definition you can understand the current is flowing through the material. Okay, so and that heat is developed due to the resistance of the material, and due to the heat the joining is happened. Okay, so in case of arc welding, so same thing also happens, means arcing will be there. Okay, due to the arcing the huge heat will be developed, and due to the heat you are welding, okay, you are going to be welded, means that filler material, okay, you are melting down the filler material that is placed inside of the two piece, okay, two wax piece. Okay, so what happened in arc welding? In this method, okay, in this method of producing the localized heat, okay, producing the localized heat based on the electricity is conducted in the form of the form of an arc, okay, which is established between two metallic surfaces. Okay, so I think you are able to understand. So that heat is developed, produced, okay, so that heat is produced due to electricity. Okay, electricity means two electrodes will be there, and current is flowing in one electrode to another electrode. Okay, in between medium is breaking down. Okay, so what happened? The huge arc will be there due to the arcing heat. Okay, that arcing heat responsible for melting down the filler material. That filler material is placed inside of the two surface. Okay, so that establish the two metallic surface. Okay, that establish the welding in between two metallic surfaces. Okay, these all are the very important and renowned welding methods. Okay, arc welding, sometimes that is called indirect arc welding, sometimes we are also called direct arc welding. Okay, so in case of arc welding, what happens? So you have give the huge voltage. Okay, so huge voltage, normally this is happened in any of the workshop, means grill, you know the grill, we have fixed up, normally we are fixing up that grill in our window. Okay, so that arc type welding happened for designing that window. Okay, what happened? So that there is a differential motor is there, sorry, differential machine is there, that may responsible for huge voltage difference, and the transformer is there, that is responsible for huge voltage provided to there, and you have placed one arc, okay, and you are make your cut piece, okay, your wax piece is in your ground. Okay, so that ground you have placed it in, that will be zero potential. Now you know that electrodes you have connected, the electrode is connected, electrodes inherent, that also the filler material. Okay, it may be coated, sometimes it uncoated. Okay, coated means insulation is there, so if you touch the electrode you are not you should not touch it. Okay, but insulation means there is a that electrode is means making the separating with the environment. Okay, there will be no options for oxidations of the surface of the electrodes. Okay, so you have placed it to that portions, means it will be melting down. Okay, it will be melting down. After melting down, so filler material will be melting and it will be took place inside of the material. So what happened? You are that electrodes you are moving inside of the filler, sorry, inside of the metallic strip, two metallic joints are there, you are moving your filler material just in between of the two faces of that metallic pieces. Okay, then what happened? It will be zero potential and is a huge high voltage terminal in between the electrodes are there. So automatically the arc will be there, and due to the arc, the huge heat will be developed, and due to the heat energy, that electrode will be automatically melting down, and it's the electrodes inherently, it's in filler material, it is melting down and sediment inside of your two metallic joint. Okay, then if you remove it, so automatically cooling down with your normal temperature and it will be joined too. That's a very common example for the arc welding, and it is famous enough for any of the shop, any of the welding shop. Okay. So what are the different processes? Okay, what are the important processes for the resistance welding? Okay, so what are the important names are there? So first one is your bar welding, then flash welding, okay, then spot welding, then seam welding, and finally projection welding. Okay, so first we will discuss about the resistance welding. Okay, so resistance welding having some sub parts. Okay, five sub parts are there. So first one is your bar welding, flash welding, spot welding, seam welding, projection welding. So one by one I will discuss elaborately. Okay, today maybe I should conclude the up to that portion. So okay, up to advantage, disadvantage. So in my next class I will start the details discussions of individual welding methodologies, from the bar welding to up to the other pending welding methodologies. Okay, so these five are the very basic examples of the welding methodology. Now what are the advantages? Okay, what are the important advantages are there for this type of welding? Okay, so some important advantages. Okay, resistance welding are given below. So first one is that both similar and dissimilar metal can be welded. Okay, means you may weld similar properties of material or dissimilar properties of metal. Okay, so you have to think about it, there should not be chemical combinations. Okay, so speaking of that material should like a manner, so there should not be any chemical changes. Okay, there should not be any presence of occurrence of chemical combinations. Okay, chemical reactions. Okay, only physical changes is possible, that due to the heat, so it will be heating down, again cool down towards the normal material. Okay, second point is that rapid welding actions. Okay, so we are using in rapid shop, in rapid applications it having, so that is advantage. Heat is localized when it is required. Okay, so localized heat can be developed. Okay, it's not like that throughout huge heat will be developed, so localized heat option should be there. Number four is the parent metal is not harmed. Okay, so you are using the filler material, so only the filler material will be melting down. Okay, and it should be sediment in between of your two metallic face. Okay, it should not be basically what happened, your filler metal your main workpiece, main workpiece. Okay, if it is more than it, so workpiece will be melted. Okay, so that's why there should not be any harm. Okay, that's the benefit. Next point is the comparatively lesser skill required. So it's not so sophisticated. So any not layman cannot be used. So experienced person, those are working, those don't have kind of methodological means some skill. Okay, so do not get the very sophisticated skill. Okay, but definitely some skill is required. Basically those are welding expert. Okay, they have lot of skill. Okay, by doing their welding in different purposes. Okay, so they have a lot of skills and their demand, huge demands are there. Those know the welding, means it's a precision, there is a good precision their work, means limited resource they are giving you more precision. Okay, that's why the demand is more. Okay, the skilled person demand is more. Next one is the difficult shape and the section can be welded. Okay, so different shape is possible. Okay, and then after that suitable for the large quantity of production, so you can use it different production unit. No filler material is required. Basically what happened, the face okay, that phase of that one, sometimes, but most of the times the filler material is required, okay. So, but most of the, but sometimes what happens, due to the heat, the phase of that materials are melting down and they are joined together, okay. So, in that case, no filler material is required, but sometimes it is also required. Okay, so what are the most important disadvantages? First disadvantages is that high initial cost. Basically, the you have to procure that welding setup. That's why the high initial cost is there. High maintenance cost. Okay, so maintenance cost also been very high. Okay, so sometimes we are using in dusty area. We are using in commercial areas, na? So commercial means in any of the plants. Okay, any of the applications, different plant applications means industries. Okay, we are using in different industries. So that's why you have to be careful about your aging effects. Okay, due to the dirty means due to the dust. Okay, everything that may happen on coating of your electrodes, okay, that may reduce the melting point of your, sorry, that may increase the melting point of your filler materials. Okay, such kind of problems may occur. So that's why the maintenance cost will be more comparatively other welding methods. So that's all of the examples and all of the advantages and disadvantages for the resistance welding. Okay, so in my next class I will discuss the individuals methodologies of what is butt welding, what is flash welding. So everything I will discuss, spot welding, then seam welding. So one by one I will discuss in my next class elaborately. Okay, at the time of exam some short note will come based on the what are the normal methodologies of welding. Okay, so these kinds of questions may arise. Okay, different methodologies, different applications, best questions may come. Okay, sometimes some numerical problem also be there. If I am able to solve some of the numerical problems to my class, that may also, you can follow that patterns. Okay, so that kinds of pattern of example will come in the time of exams. Okay, so why I am telling you all the time to practice the numerical problems? Basically at the time of exam, maybe 40% theory, 60% numerical problem. Okay, or reverse also being possible. Basically it's an informative subject, so 60% theory, sometimes 40% numerical, maybe 50% theory, 50% numerical. So numericals problems are also very important. So I am sure I have already solved some pattern of the numerical problems to my previous lectures. Okay, so you can follow them. Basically try to solve the assignments. Okay, so at the time of exam you will get the you may get some chances to same pattern of numerical problem. Okay, so that's the basic motivation to solving the numerical problem to my class. I think all of you are able to understand. These portions are very simple and I think you are able to understand. Okay, there is no such big kind of confusions. So here I am concluding my today's session, means today's lecture. So next class I will discuss about the details discussions of the new different welding methodologies of resistance welding, then arc welding, and their different categories or different features. Okay, advantage, disadvantage I have discussed, and discussed about different classifications of that welding methodologies. Okay, thank you. Now after the